Hello, my name is Shay Carpenter. I would like to start by saying thank you for your dedication to the students of Denver. This is my 10th year in the field of education. However, this is the first board meeting that I've ever had to attend. This has been a year of firsts for me. This has been the first year I've had to question the integrity of the school system of which I was employed. This has been the first school year in which I was consistently blocked from advocating for the needs of my staff, my school, my students, and their families. This has been the only job I have walked away from. The harassment and disrespect of which I endured forced me to make the choice to walk away from my students and their families, a choice I did not make with ease, and one of which continues to leave me in turmoil. I accepted my teaching position as the Intermediate Plex program teacher at Ellis Elementary School last March with great joy and anticipation for the vision of Denver Public Schools. I took the promise of putting students first at face value. I believed. I took a position teaching students with traumatic brain injury and autism spectrum disorder in a school where inclusion of these students was not only welcomed, but valued. At the opening of the school year, I was told that the Plex program at this elementary school was now a self-contained program where students new to the program were to be in a special education setting for at least 60% of their school day with little regard for least restrictive environment or individual needs. With the support of Ellis staff and administration, I took steps to convey our collective vision for the inclusion of Plex students. I asked for an additional paraprofessional to support the needs of these students in their general education classrooms, as well as to support the collective mission of general education staff in allowing every child to succeed. Following steps taken to advocate for my school and my students, I began to be harassed and threatened by district staff, hoping to force my compliance with a self-contained setting. I was told I would never receive additional para support, and that if students could not be independent in their general education classrooms, they should be in the special education setting until they could work their way into the general education classroom. This logic is unlawful. Recently, following continuous demands from Advocacy Denver, district staff have finally agreed to speak with parents and students in the Plex program about program changes and to hear their voice. This opportunity for parents was something that I put together in November and was quickly told that if I followed through with a parent meeting, I would lose my job. My hope for DPS is for policymakers to continue to develop their understanding of the inherent values of students with special needs in a way in which they are valued across the country. My hope is for DPS to uphold the assertion that every child succeeds and to take the steps to ensure that students with exceptionalities are provided the resources without their parents having to hire advocates to reach their highest potential. If I were a board member, I will be done in 1 second. I would want to ensure that all students walked away knowing that their gifts were not only supported, but valued, and that their vision for success was also my vision for success. It is not only their right, but your obligation. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Carpenter.